Well, this is probably one of the greatest opportunities that Gene and I have had, your grandma and grandpa. We had a year's sabbatical from Cal Poly. They paid me while I did a study in Europe about teacher training programs. And we bought a car in Europe and drove it for the year all over Europe. And you can see we're in Germany, and here we drove over to where the old Berlin Wall was, and that was quite an experience. And then we traveled, I think we traveled to about 25 or 30 countries of Western Europe. And these are just different scenes. You can see probably that's Rome. This might be the beer garden where Hitler did his initial actions and got so much. And we had a lot of, we stayed at bed and breakfast almost all the time. This is up in Sweden, this great big park that they have there, this sculptor's work. And that was quite a outstanding experience for Gene and I. And these are the dikes of Holland, and the windmills, of course, and some of the countryside there, and the lowlands of Holland. And we came, just kept driving around different places, and enjoyed the weather up there. It was great when we first started out. Those are the white cliffs of Dover, of England. And we're on a ship coming with our car across the English Channel. And now we're in England, going on one of the boats on the river. This is one of those huge burial sites for American dead that died in World War II, saving Europe from Nazi Germany. And we went to the Stonehenge. That's what's going on behind us there. Very unusual experience. Idea, the concept. I don't know. I still don't know how they did it. We're able to move those huge stones. There's a lot of theories, but it was pretty remarkable. And now you can see maybe the weather's getting a little chillier. We're dressing a little. And here we're at the, in Ireland, where you kiss the Blarney Stone, and then you have the Blarney, the gift of Blarney, or the gift of talk. So you had to lean back. This guy held you. It was about three stories up. If you slipped, you just went. Then we saw a lot of British soldiers up in Ireland there. And this was one of our students that we helped mind. He's a Rotary Scholar. And we met him in London. And he was here in San Luis Obispo for about 5 years. It's a great Rosetta Stone. I touched that. I felt like that was really reaching back in history. One of the guards at the castle. Getting a little colder now. We're getting cooler and cooler. And this is the Normandy landing site. Gene going up and down. This is one of the pillboxes there. If you stay in Europe for very long, you run into all kinds of sleeping accommodations. Very unusual. Some of that French coast was just absolutely magnificent. But cold, it was getting colder. We were being driven south because it was getting colder. Now, Sharon and Karen flew over at Christmas time to be with us while we traveled around Europe. And they spent 2 or 3 weeks with us as we went from places in Spain and Portugal. And that's what these scenes are about. They visited us, and I think they had a good time. We certainly enjoyed having their company with us. And that was one of their last big flings before they started getting married and having children. So this is along the Spanish coast there. We enjoyed the life. Those colorful boats that they had. How two hearts met. Along the beaches, we really love the beaches. This is up in Portugal, one of the king's castles. And we wanted to give a little idea of the shopping. We did some shopping on the local market. We ate a lot of meals out. Gene did a lot of cooking. Then closed me. That's a good life right there, just sitting and watching the world go by. This is New Year's Eve and Christmas Eve, and we were over at the Rock of Gibraltar, and then we drove up the coast further up into through Spain and up into France. We enjoyed that up there. And this is probably more of the Rock of Gibraltar. We stayed there for a couple, 3 days, traveled in and out. We had timeshares over there that we stayed in when the kids were with us. This is the original bull ring in the world. And one of the great matadors is buried right in the middle of that bull ring. This is when we went over from Gibraltar to Morocco. And we got to see some very nice things. There's Moroccan camel. And Karen was brave enough to ride it. Sharon up there looking the world over from the top of the camel. And they are a little tricky getting up and down. And again, I don't think their liability insurance would be worth very much. But it worked out for us. And you can see the Islamic artwork and Islamic area of Morocco. Very, you know, it is an Islamic state. And then that's Great Britain. We flew back, we bought some stuff, flew back to Gibraltar.
I thought the world held not but joy.
I think this is one of those Moroccan castles. Then we went up to Toledo, and drove around up there, and these are some folks we met. And the Roman architecture just permeated that whole part of Europe. They were a powerful force. That was a Roman aqueduct that they used. We're back down along the coast there in Spain. And this is one of those Roman Colosseums. It isn't in Rome itself. It's down in Spain, but it's supposed to have seated about 100,000 people. The Romans really are a dominant force. This is down in where the gambling casino is there in Spain. I can't think of the name of it. Trying to say Monte Cristo, but that isn't right. Here's the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Really enjoyed that. We walked along the outside of the Leaning Tower all the way to the top. And that you can't do that today, but at that time that was acceptable. It's quite an experience. The United States had just bombed Libya. They were very concerned for our safety. We hold up at an army base there in Italy for a while, for a couple of weeks, because I have access to there. And this is Venice, one of the big squares in Venice. And we're traveling around different towns. This was during one of the big elections in Austria. This is the Olympic site in Austria, where they had this Snow Olympics, the Winter Olympics. Then we went down into a big tunnel, and they made us wear these clothing because of the way you had to get down there and slide. They didn't want you to get your own clothes real dirty. This is a trip that we took down through the Panama Canal on a ship with Karen. Karen met some awfully nice people on that trip. We have some great stories about getting off the ship there in Panama at 3 in the morning and driving into the main town in a taxi. And that was quite an experience. This young fellow there was pretty sweet on Karen at that time. And he showed us around. He was Panamanian, and he showed us around the town a little bit, gave us some tours.